Welcome back to another episode of Fill in the Trade, where we play fake GMs for a day. Today we're talking about Reggie Jackson. Reggie Jackson this year averaging 22.4 points, 8.1 assists, 4.0 rebounds per game. So having a career year with the absence of Russell Westbrook and co. there. Now, what we want to talk about is, let's just say they want to capitalize on this high play. Where do we go from here? My name's Phil Boileau, and we're joined today by Justin Rowan. Justin, I know you've been thinking about this one. Where would Reggie Jackson theoretically make a lot of sense if he were to get traded?
Well, I mean, the whole reason that he would be up for being traded is the same thing they saw with James Harden. With the presence of Russell Westbrook there, a dominant ball handler, he may want to go to another location where he can be the man, he can star, and he's showing the capability for that. What I have in mind for Reggie Jackson is sending him to Philly. Right now, Philly's got a team that's basically bare bones. In return, sending him and Perry Jones to Philly, you get Nerlens Noel. So you got a shot-blocking big, someone with tremendous upside that can really help anchor an Oklahoma City team that's really been starving of that center. And then, because Reggie Jackson could leave at the beginning of next season or this offseason, you get Perry Jones, who has shown a little bit. He's got some upside. He's got 2 years left on his deal. So that's a bit of an insurance package and an incentive for Philly to do that. I don't know if they need another second-round pick or something thrown in there, but it's a mutually beneficial trade for both teams. Obviously, there's some risk with Noel and free agency for Reggie Jackson creates risk, but it's a calculated risk for both teams.
Well, I think it makes a lot of sense. Some of the risk would surround around, you know, the two-center position there with OKC in a little bit. Since they have Steven Adams is going to come off the books, I believe a year ahead of Noel, then they'll have to deal with where they want to put their money. But I guess that'll allow them to play the two-headed monster for a bit and see who develops and pay the money to the guy who develops quicker, I guess. And let's be honest, having Nerlens Noel next to Serge Ibaka would be quite the defensive dynamo. And let's not pretend Adams is a poor defender either way. I actually really like this for the 76ers also. I know it's hard to trade away a center, a young athletic center, especially in this NBA, deprived of such a talent. But Perry Jones, as you've said, has played well in Durant's absence, has a broad repertoire, and having Reggie Jackson in that trade allows him to play next to Michael Carter-Williams, which Carter Williams now playing point guard, big point guard, allows him to be interchangeable. They still have Joel Embiid. So Joel Embiid, Perry Jones, Michael Carter-Williams, Reggie Jackson, there's a lot of future. And I think that on both sides makes a lot of sense. But we're talking a bit off camera about the realistic bit of trading a guy like Reggie Jackson. Doesn't make a lot of money right now. Do you think he realistically gets moved?
I don't think that there's a high likelihood of him getting traded. I mean, I don't foresee a lot of teams taking that risk. Just building off of what you were saying earlier about Steven Adams being there, Nerlens Noel's been playing a fair bit of power forward as well for Philly, and that's something that they want to implement. So if you have a competition between those two players on who's going to be the starting center, and whoever's backup gets to play minutes, like let's say 25 minutes a game at both backup center and power forward, then you have a situation that might be conducive to a three-headed monster with those two and Ibaka. The only reason I bring up Philly is just because of the position that they're in. They might be willing to take that risk, and I think it would take a unique situation like that for a team to gamble on Reggie Jackson. I think OKC is going to try to move him and capitalize, but I don't think there's going to be a lot of teams looking to take that risk.
No, exactly, because he is free agent at the end of this year, restricted free agent, albeit. But the conversation stems with his play improving with game to game without Westbrook or Durant to take shots away. I mean, as we said at the beginning of the show, his numbers are all-star-esque this year. So in a league where it's point guard-driven league, his value will be very high, but they realize he is a free agent. Now, we've seen some comparables in terms of projections of salary. I've seen between 13 and 15 a year with the numbers he's putting up and the age he is, the size for his position. I could go on and on. Some people even compared him to a better version of an Eric Bledsoe who landed about a $14, $15 million contract. So I guess the question bears, if he's close to that max contract, is this something that OKC, do you see them going over the salary cap? Well, I know it's going to expand a bit, but where they didn't want to do it for Harden, I think that's the interesting point.
Right, and I don't foresee OKC really breaking out the checkbooks for this yet. I mean, they still got Perkins on contract for inexplicable reasons. It's a lot of money to put into a team when you already have three max guys, which is why getting cheap help from a guy like Noel would be so beneficial to them, because at this point they need to capitalize on cheap veterans on their final contracts and young productive rookies and guys still on their rookie salary. Again, part of the incentive for Philly is they already have two centers in Noel and Embiid, and this center or this draft coming up that they're going to be drafting high in is filled with big men. It's very rare to see a draft like this. But
although it's a big risk, right? If you're trading a top chip player like Noel, how some people see him, as we said, Reggie Jackson is not signed. So wouldn't you want some assurance? I mean, if you're gonna give away a guy like Noel, wouldn't you want to wait to the offseason, have this guy sign, and you know, maybe have an under-the-table handshake agreement with OKC saying, listen, you can sign him considering we're under the cap floor.
Right.
We'll still give you these guys. We'll just eat up this money, and we'll give you it later. Because at least that way, because you're giving away Noel, I think he has 3 or 4 years left on his rookie. You know, that's tough for good production. Because if Reggie Jackson walks away, because let's face it, Philly is not an instant contender. I mean, as many Rihanna fans as they're going to have because of Joel Embiid, it's not going to be the reason why Reggie Jackson stays there. So he kind of has to be contractually obligated to stay there. Do you think this is something in the offseason? Now, refresh my mind, if OKC did decide to match or sign him outright to a quite lucrative deal, how long would they have to wait to trade him to a team like Philly?
They'd have to wait until about December 15th. It takes a while for you to be allowed to do that. And when you're looking for some sort of an assurance for Philly, I mean, they're in a very different situation than what OKC is in. OKC has three guys on near-max contracts. Philly's got nobody like that right now. They're barely at the cap floor. So when you trade for a guy like Reggie Jackson, you also acquire his RFA rights. And when you have his RFA rights, if he decides, hey, I'm going to go sign with the Sacramento Kings, or I'm going to
just match on anybody once that happens.
You match. So you have that insurance policy. You're able to overpay because at this point they don't really need to be that frugal financially because they just have so much room and the cap's shooting up. So it's an opportunity that they can capitalize on. They have a surplus of potential big men, which, I mean, you're talking about risk for them. OKC, we don't know what Nerlens Noel's going to be. We don't know if he's going to be another Greg Oden and just break down constantly. I personally think he's going to be very good, and that's why I think that this trade has the potential to work out. But both sides are assuming some risk, but it seems like Philly would be getting the more known commodity in this transaction.
I think this works really well, and I think this was well thought out by you. I'm actually an OKC and 76ers fan, and for once I actually am excited for both if this ever went down. Because as we said, Reggie Jackson's probably not staying. Landing a four-year deal with Nerlens Noel, even if he only does what he's doing right now, next to Ibaka and two other high-volume, high-usage scorers, not a bad deal. Well, guys, we're going to catch you next time on another Fill in the Trade, where we bring players and teams to the forefront. We put players where they need to be. We put teams with the moving parts to make them better, and we always bring it in a fun and entertaining way. So from Justin and myself, thanks for joining, and catch you next time in the lounge.